Vsauce, Kevin here. Go to a restaurant, look at the menu, and then eat it. Molecular gastronomy is an innovative way of cooking that combines culinary arts with science. As food is prepared and combined in what's called a colloidal system, ingredients go through physical and chemical changes. Chefs utilizing molecular gastronomy use their artistic and technical abilities to influence the food's transformations. These techniques turn boring traditional cuisine into a modern sensory experience. By looking at food simply as states of matter in different types of colloidal systems, foam, solid foam, gel, emulsion, and solid emulsion, molecular gastronomists prepare unique dishes like this deconstructed baby corn, or this creative take on lemon chicken. And they bring unique tools into the kitchen such as hypodermic syringes for spherification, which involves liquid-filled beads that create gel equivalents of foods ranging from caviar to ravioli. The vacuum machine is used to suck out air from a bag in order to use a cooking technique called sous vide, which slowly cooks the food in heated water to retain moisture. Or another important tool that they use, liquid nitrogen. Robin Sue Fisher, founder of Smitten Ice Cream in San Francisco, wanted to make ice cream as fresh as possible that didn't require a bunch of chemicals to preserve, and her solution was liquid nitrogen. It's nitrogen at an extremely low temperature in a liquid state, first liquefied at Jagiellonian University in 1883 by Polish physicists Zygmunt Wroblewski and Karol Olszewski. By using liquid nitrogen, Fisher found that she could rapidly freeze ice cream, allowing her to make each serving fresh right when a customer orders. Chef Hamaro Cantu at Moto Restaurant in Chicago makes edible menus. And this bread and butter menu was one of the first. Cantu's masticable menus include one printed on a salad roll, which after reading the menu, the customer just rolls it up and eats it. For printing, they use a modified inkjet printer with cartridges filled with food-based ink, like juiced carrots, tomatoes, and purple potatoes. One of Moto's most innovative courses is a play on fried chicken, in which noodles and biscuits are made with dehydrated, freeze-dried chicken ground into a powder. If you want to experiment with molecular gastronomy yourself, the YouTube channel Molecule R Flavors has tutorials anyone can follow with the right ingredients. Like this frozen chocolate wind that uses soy lecithin, which is a natural emulsifier that changes watery solutions into an air-like substance. Or these surprise bubbles that use calcium lactate and sodium alginate derived from brown algae to create spheres. You can also check out their website that offers kits with everything you need to try molecular gastronomy techniques at home. Enthusio Chefs is another great channel that features videos like this reverse spherified poached egg that uses xanthan gum, a mixture of two calcium salts called gluco, and egg white powder to recreate just the whites of a poached egg. They also make powdered ice cream inside candy strawberries, and milk, where they use milk to make cheese and foam to create this. And while to some molecular gastronomy could be considered a novelty, it does combine science, technology, creativity, and sustenance in exciting ways. And really, I just kind of want to try strawberry spaghetti. What about cheeseburger spaghetti? Pizza spaghetti? And as always, thanks for watching.